Hey guys, welcome back. Welcome back to another stream. We are in London. We're in good old London town. We're going to be doing some air ambulance work in the awesome Augusta 139. It's been a long time since I've flown this aircraft. I'm not 100% sure if I know how to even fucking start the thing up. We are on VATSIM, and there's quite a bit of ATC around about the London area, so I need to make sure that I am checked in on the reckon. So we have London SC 1326. That's probably going to be me. In fact, it'll be 1358 because he'll be looking after the lower sector. Right, let's see if I can remember how to start this thing. I have set my controls and stuff up. Hey, welcome back, Clowny. Captain Danny, good to see you, Big Dog. Welcome along. What's up, Loris? Welcome. Stop asking me how I'm fucking doing, Loris. Right. We'll need the rotor brake off, first of all. That'll help. Right. What else? What else do we need, guys? I remember this now. Master battery, that needs to be on. Oh, nothing happened. Oh, that's because it's a master bus. That one. And now this one.
Flying heading 115, speedbird 7-8.
Land on control, speedbird 7-8, Mike uniform. Good evening, sir. Descending flight level 130 to Oka.
Speedbird 7-8, Mike uniform, radar control. Hello, descend flight level 90.
Descend 90, speedbird 7-8, Mike uniform.
Forgot I would turn the radio off.
EZ-19 uniform, Zulu, route direct to Benbow.
Direct Benbow, EZ-19 uniform, Zulu.
Hey, Luca, welcome back, champ. Good to see you, my main man, my captain's club buddy. Good to see you, brother. Welcome. Yeah, I'm just trying to remember how to start this bitch. none of that. Right, anti-collision position lights, strobe, pilot, PO heat. And I remember that we do something. Right, we do with the throttles, go to flight straight away. Into flight, and that's it. Category alpha switch is set, trim is set, controls are unlocked and responsive. Roger.
Right.
I hear you, love. Hydraulic one and two, not yet. I've forgotten where the feckin' start switch is, guys. Oh, I remember now. I need the fuel valve open for engine number one and the fuel pump open. I need a fuel valve open for engine number two and the fuel pump on. And there is a start switch somewhere. Where is it? It's not down here. Aha, yeah, I remember my engine rating modes. So the fuel is on. How much fuel do we actually have? Actually, that's a good question. How much fuel do we have? We have enough fuel. Right, so the engine rating to idle for one. Stuff's happening, guys! Mo Daddy on Twitch says, do you only fly helicopters? No, dude, you just missed me fly the Harrier jump jet on DCS. Right, this should stabilise at 55, and it has done. So now we can go for flight. And that'll power up. Rotor brake is off. And we have 94, it should stabilize 95. And we can go for idle on the rating mode for engine 2. Wait for that to stabilize out at 55. Yeah, Mo, if you go onto my YouTube channel, you can check out the stream. Alright, we're looking for 55 stable. 55 stable we have, and take the engine 2 rating to flight. Hey, Bike Life, welcome. I would rather that you watched on YouTube, Mo Daddy, but it's really up to you, bro. It's really up to you, my friend. The wind is 240 at 9 knots. Alright, we should be good. I'm using Active Sky for clouds. Do I fly with the trim systems on? Depends. Right, clear this. 135.8. I've got my pen and a bit of paper ready in case we have any instructions that we're not familiar with or we're not expecting. I just want to quickly take off and just see if I can still remember how to fly this thing. Alright, so I need my the rotor RPM set to 102%. And that is set. Alright, we need the nose up.
I think 300 degrees from starboard and look wise, 27 left to 75 past. Number 267.
Nose is up.
Speedboat 78 Mike, uniform, just
and
set your
altitude there. Coming in a little ground effect hover.
Zero, but you can descend now to altitude 4,000 feet, QNH 998.
And stabilise. Oh, this is nice and smooth. You can tell it has a stability augmentation system, a very good SAS system working. Alright, we'll do a spot turn to the right.
Roger.
And then we'll do a spot turn to the left.
London, this is Rhino 27 Golf Mike, or 27 FK, we're coming landborne 2X ray through 4,200.
Rhino 27 Golf Mike, London Control, hello. Climb flight level 130, heading 070 degrees.
Doesn't like
up to 130
the
and flight 130 and 070 degrees on the head in Ryanair 27 Golf Mike.
Alright, spot to the right. Stabilise. And spot to the left. A little too high, bro. Nose down. This is a difficult part, getting the tail through the tailwind. Keep going, keep going, keep going, keep going. A little scraggly at the back, but that's okay. We'll touch
right at 27 Gulf Mike, redirect now to Welling.
A little bit forward.
Direct to Welling, Ryanair 27 Golf Mike.
Oh, Jesus, get down. Alright, main gear. Down. Nose. Down. That wasn't so bad. Hey, Truth Settlement, is the Northeast Air Ambulance available in the mod? Yes, Truth, the UK Air Ambulance is available for everywhere in the United Kingdom. So you can fly, you can actually fly anywhere in the world, but it'll be UK ambulances and stuff like that. Mo Daddy on Twitch says, I found your channel from the Concorde flights. Nice, bro. Hey, my main man Lucas back. Good to see you, Lucas. Welcome back, Captain. Right, so let's check in with London Control. We have information echo at Heathrow, which is 9 or 9 or 8. So I need to do the fucking conversion on this. Alright, hold on. I just need to convert the hectopascals. QNH conversion. Millibars to inches is what we're looking for.
Golf Mike, contact London, 132
9 or 8 is...
132.6, thank you, Ryanair, 27 Golf Mike.
29 or 47. Where is that switch again? That is somewhere here. That's it there. 29 or 47. Tactical Pete on Twitch says, I've gotten a ride in a 139 before. Cool as hell. That's very cool indeed, sir. That's awesome.
78 my uniform left heading 360 degrees.
London Control, good evening. Helimed 27 Echo.
Helimed 27 Echo, London, hello.
Hello sir, we're Augusta 139, we're with you at RAF Norfolk. We'd like to enter controlled airspace on track for the Royal London Hospital, eastbound on Hotel 10 to Perivale, and then Perivale direct to the Royal London Hospital.
Helimed 27 Echo, London, thanks. Clear then to London Control Zone. Hotel 10 eastbound, Perivale, then Royal London direct. Standard operating altitude initially, and the London QNH 998 hectopascal, squawk 3753.
Clear to enter controlled airspace on track, Royal London, eastbound on Hotel 10, Perivale, and then direct Royal London. Standard operating altitudes 9 or 9 or 8 is the QNH, and 3753 the squawk confirmed for Helimed 27 Echo.
Helimed 27 Echo, that is all correct. Lift at your discretion. The surface wind at Northolt 24010.
Helimed 27 Echo, many thanks. 3753.
My uniform turn left heading 280 degrees. I'm going to establish 27 left to send me the glide.
280 degrees left, and now we're establishing the IS.
Squawk Charlie is set. Alright, we can lift at our discretion as per the ATC instructions. You know you can just check the QNH on Active Sky and it tells you an inch. Oh, Luca, you fucking legend, does it? Let me have a quick look. Bob Saget. So it does, bro. God damn it. Thanks, Luca. Fucking legend. Thanks, brother. Alright, let's go. Alright, roar RPM set to 102%. Let's get the nose up. And we want the right wheel off the ground first. And up. Stabilize. And we're doing a category alpha departure. Back and left. Here we go. Category Alpha switch selected. Up we go.
3178 white uniform, call tower 118.5. Here's coming.
118.5, explosions. Thanks. Thank you.
Well, it's good to be back in the 139. Alright, nose forward, wait for physics to catch up. Take a little bit of collective off, and left pedal. RPM back to 100%. Away we go. Hey, Bike of Life, thanks man, you take care of yourself. And we're off. We're a little low, but that's okay. Oh, here's these stupid vapor effects again. Right, we're heading for Perivale, which is just along this road. Perivale is just here on the map. I'll zoom in, you'll be able to see it. Look, there's Perivale right there. And from Perivale, normally we would turn south and go straight down Ealing.
But we actually have clearance to go direct from Pennyvale to the Royal London Hospital. Hey Lewis, I actually live in a new house, bro. I moved house. That's why it looks different. Hey Lewis, welcome. That's the turn for Ealing. We're not going to go down there though. We're going to keep going straight towards the Royal London Hospital. And we're going to pick up our medical team. Thanks, Lewis. Windows, no, this is the face cam is not new, brother, no. You just don't watch the stream enough, that's all, brother. Fucking buster.
571 London, hello, direct Ockham.
Hey, Ockham, 3.2571.
Subject 429, flighting 050 degrees.
How do you feel about the new flight sim? It's a bit basic. I'm going to wait until we get like Concorde and stuff like that in the new Microsoft Flight Simulator before I really get involved. We're heading to these high-rise buildings right in front of us.
Under control, good evening, flyer 17 Bravo with you. Ooh. Flight level 170, heading 160.
They were supposed to be on.
17 Bravo, London, thank you. Descent flight level 9, correction 120.
Descent flight level 120, flyer 17 Bravo.
Under control, hello again, it's shuttle 2.
I don't think you can get helicopters in Microsoft Flight Simulator just yet, Tactical Pete.
Shuttle 24 Alpha, London control, hello, climb flight level 140.
I've got level 140, shouldn't be for Alpha.
Alright, a little bit too much torque on, we'll bring that back.
Speedbird 2571, descent flight level 90.
Descent level 90, speedbird 2571.
Right at 9, Papa November, call London 132.6, goodbye.
132.6, bye.
Subject 49er, flighting 040 degrees.
040 degrees, subject 49.
They're not really smoke trails, it's like it's a very bad vapour effect, sadly. Doesn't look that great.
Speedbird 390, Romeo 8 navigation, direct to Vabik.
London Helimed 27 Echo, we have the Royal London Insight.
Helimed 27 Echo, thank you. London City's 240 degrees, 10 knots.
27 Echo.
Tomjet 429, report your heading to London 132.6, goodbye.
132.6, Tomjet 429, thank you.
Goodbye.
Okay, there's a hospital there on the left hand side.
London 132.6, goodbye.
Start slowing down now. One's coming from 240 at 9 knots. Gear's coming down.
Shuttle 24 Alpha, call London 132.6, goodbye.
132.6. bye-bye.
London, good evening, Ryanair 90, Mike Fox, flight level 80, heading 290 degrees.
Ryanair 90, Mike Fox, London, hello to you. Flight heading 310 degrees and climb flight level 120.
Okay, the airspeed is down below 90 knots. We'll take the rotor RPM now to 102%. Set. The gear is down, three greens. Category Alpha switch is pressed. So we're going to left pedal round here and get the nose into wind.
Fly 17 Bravo, descent flight level 80.
Descent flight level 80, fly 17 Bravo.
Ryanair 90, Mike Foxtrot, report you're heading to London 132.6.
Okay,
goodbye.
The nose is into wind now. I'm just going to crab a little bit more to the left so I can just reset and come back in from the east side. Careful with my rate of descent here.
Welcome, heading
075. Alright, get control. Way too fast for this stage, dude. Alright, let's get the nose back into wind. The gear is down, three grades.
517 Bravo, turn right, heading 185.
Right, let's crab
in. Alright,
good visual on the pad. I'm happy with the forward trend. Power's good, vertical speed is good, and the airspeed is good.
Control, good evening. Air France 189er, 5,000 feet. Climb.
Yes, Wolf, this is the Augusta 139, my friend.
Air France 189 London, hello, climb flight level 170.
Climbing flight level 170, Air France 189er.
Fly 17 Bravo, descent.
Alright, stabilising the ground effect. Put the nose straight into wind. Stabilise. Don't go any further forward than this. And let's get the main gear down. Left wheel first.
999
Bravo. Touching down. And nose gear down. Gently lower the collective, centre the cyclic and neutral pedals. We're down.
We just crossed the Air France 189er, route direct Benbow. Air France 189er, direct Benbow.
I really want to figure out how to remember how to turn the goddamn radio off. What switch is that again?
No navigation, direct Lambo, mile 17 Bravo.
Shamrock 154 London, hello, direct Bovington, descent flight.
Thank God. Right, so let's get a job. Alright, we definitely don't want to take the patient to Edinburgh. QRLH for the Royal London Hospital. And we'll do a minimum distance of 10 miles, maximum distance of 25 miles. And we'll see what comes up first, and then we'll maybe get a job out towards Heathrow, an RTC between a bus and a child. So let's just quickly find out where this is before we accept it. Well, Morgan, yes, this is the X-Rotors Augusta 139. Ooh, this is actually a good one, guys. Out by Beaconsfield. There's Uxbridge. Cookham. Okay, so we're responding to a road traffic collision. A child has been struck by a bus after running out into the road and is now in a critical condition with serious internal injuries. The patient was in cardiac arrest and given CPR by a bystander before being resuscitated on scene. They are now being given pre-hospital emergency anaesthesia in preparation to fly to the trauma room. Make sure you know exactly where the incident is located. It would also be a great idea to quickly plan a flight back to the hospital too. Any delays could cost this child their life. Get to the scene as fast as you can and let's save this kid. Roger, start mission. We have 33 minutes to make it. Rotor RPM back to 100%. Right, let's get our clearance back into controlled airspace. Right, so we want Hotel
17 Bravo, descent to altitude 3000
feet. Hotel 10 westbound to Cookham.
Descent 3000 feet, lab no reports established, Flight 17 Bravo.
Who is this controller, actually? I want this guy's name. I like this guy. Oh, there it is. Oh, it's Fraser. I like Fraser. It's got very... Fraser's got great brevity, great pitch, pace and tone as well. Helimed 27 Alpha.
Hello, 27 Alpha, London, good.
Hello, sir. We're responding to an Alpha call in Woodburn. We're ready to lift on the Royal London Hospital. We'd like to enter controlled airspace westbound on Hotel 10, direct to Perivale, and leave in controlled airspace at Cookham.
Hello, 27 Alpha London, roger. So you cleared to enter the London control zone, Woodburn, Hotel 10 westbound, Perivale, then Cookham, as requested. Initially standard operating altitude, QNH remains at 999 hectopascal.
Clear to enter controlled airspace on track for Woodburn, Hotel 10 westbound Perivale, and leaving controlled airspace at Cookham. Standard operating altitudes 9 or 9 or 9 or for Helimed 27 Alpha. We're lifting now.
27 Alpha, thank you. 230 at 10. Brake speed at 2571 at 360 degrees.
Left head 360 degrees, speed at 2571.
Alright, 1 and 2 are up and looking good.
Rotor
RPM to 102%. We are ready to go. Clear on the left, clear on the right. Flight for both engines. We're ready to go. Alright, Category Alpha is set.
259.
Nose up.
2571, sorry. Left 295 when established. 27 left, descend with the glide.
Left 295 when established. 27 left, descend glide path sweep with 2571.
And right wheel up first and stabilise into ground effect here. And we're going to come back and left. Up we go.
Lot 27 Echo London, hello, descent flight level 90.
Gear up. Alright, let's go.
Speedboat 2571, descent order to 3,000 feet, further glide.
3,000 feet, further glide, speedboat 2571.
Alright, we're through ETL, rotor RPM back to 100%, the gear is up. Ernest on YouTube says, is there quite a lot of detailed UK scenery to buy? Yes! The Orbic scenery, Ernest, has almost photoreal scenery for the United Kingdom, and you can buy it for UK South, UK Central and UK North. I have all three packs.
Lot 27 Echo after Sabre, fly heading 250 degrees.
Alright, we're heading direct for Perivale now. Hey Omar, welcome. Check the horn. Sounds good.
Oh, shit. 17 Bravo established, ILS 27.
Flying straight towards that building.
Runway 27 cleared to land, surface wind 240 degrees.
Alright, let's get a bit more altitude, fuck's sake.
Cleared to land 27, fly 17 Bravo.
Speedboat 2571, contact tower 118.5, good 8.
Tower 118.5, speedboat 2571, cheer.
That sounds like Lewis.
Lot 27 Echo, descent flight level 80, expect.
I'm actually going to check to see if that is Lewis. Who was it, speedboat 2571? It is Lewis! One of my favourite controllers.
4,999.
Yeah, look, I have nearly 1 terabyte worth of scenery for X-Plane.
well, not 1 terabyte, but you know what I'm talking about. I got a lot, bro. I have the... So I also have Orbix Washington, Orbix Oregon, Orbix North California, Orbix South California. So yeah, I got a lot of space, dude. I got a lot of disk space taken up by X-Plane. Almost a perivale. Oh, I also have Orbix Florida as well, Luca. Thanks for reminding me, brother. Superboy says Spain HD is like 400 gig. That's one of the ones that I don't have yet, Spain. I don't really fly there very often. I don't fly there at all, to be honest. Only go to Spain if we're going to Gibraltar and Concord. Alright, joining Perivale now. It's this road just down here, and we're going to follow that westbound until we pass RAF Norfolk, then we're going to go to Uxbridge, then we go to Iverheath, and from Iverheath we go to Cookham, and from Cookham we're going to go straight to our incident. We're going to fly very close to London Heathrow, very, very close. We're only going to be about 3 or 4 miles north of Heathrow in a moment or two. Looking good, feeling good.
Super 829, I leave Bovington on a heading of 125.
Leave Bovington on a heading of 295, B-Bird 829.
Heading 125.
Heading 125, Seabird 829.
Shamrock 154, right, heading 255, when established, 27 left, descend glide.
255, when
established. Hey, Josh, thanks for the sub on YouTube, bro, welcome to the channel. Alright, it's a 23 mile flight, so. We're just coming up for about halfway, guys. It's not going to take us too much longer to get there.
Lot 27 echo, descent altitude 5.
Heathrow's going to be on the left-hand side, so there's Heathrow right there. I need to drink more water, I'm getting a really sore head. Alright, so here comes one of our junctions in the sky at RAF Norfolk here, where we're going to turn slightly to the left for Uxbridge once we get past here. And then at Uxbridge, we're going to go to Iverheath. There's Uxbridge on the map up there. So this is the RAF Norfolk on the right side of the aircraft. This is where the HEMS helicopters are based for London in real life, down here. To Uxbridge and then to Iverheath.
Chapter 154, call the tower 118.5,
okay. 118.5, Shamrock
Airbus 737, it's just a really bad, it's a bad vapour effect, it's not that great. We're not actually smoking, it's just, it's supposed to be vapour coming off the little wings at the back there. It's not a very good effect, sadly. Right, coming left for Ivor Heath.
Lot 27 Echo left heading 245.
245 I'm heading. I've been up since half past two in the morning is when I got up this morning. I am very, very, very tired. I need to try and stay awake till about midnight. I start a back shift tomorrow. I start work at half past two in the afternoon. I'm probably going to be working till about midnight, so I need to make sure that I am well rested. Here's the
M25.
Hey, roundabout, good to see you, you fucking buster. Welcome, sir. It's been a long time. Hope you're well. Alright, we're coming right for Cookham now. This is Ivor Heath. I'm living a dream, thanks brother. As always. I live the dream every day, bro. Thank you. Hey, Cown Hilly person, welcome on YouTube. Good to see you, brother.
Control, good evening.
Easy 9009, passing 260. Easy 9009, London. Hello, descend flight level 90, direct timber.
Descend flight level 90, direct
timber. Oh, I've got a really bad headache, guys. I got a really sore head. I think this is going to be quite a short stream. I might just do this one flight and then go and chill out. My head is pounding. I'm just dehydrated. I've drank way too much coffee today and I've not drank enough water, so my brain is starting to punish me for that.
Lot 27 Echo, just confirm you maintain 220 knots still. Speedwood 829, turn right heading 200.
Hey Alex, welcome. We're actually doing air ambulance work. Roundabout's asking on Twitch if I'm doing search and rescue. We're doing more air ambulance stuff rather than search and rescue. We're responding to a road traffic collision between a child and a bus. So unfortunately, a child has been hit by a bus and desperately needs to get to the hospital as quickly as possible. So we're just flying out via the heli routes and then we're going to be heading north very soon. Element 27 Alpha, basic service. We're leaving Cookham now for Beaconsfield.
Roger. A very good evening, Virgin 25 Bravo, I'm at 1 Fox, passing 2600.
Virgin 25 Bravo, London, good evening, climb flight level 140.
I love this controller. This guy sounds so professional, I love him. What's up, Marin? Welcome. We're going to Beaconsfield in London, bro. Chimera says, too much blood in the beer stream. Bro, I don't even drink alcohol. I don't even drink alcohol, dude. So it can't be that. Alright, this instance should be somewhere. There it is, there. Look. There's the bus that hit the kid. There's the ambulance. There's the police.
Speedbird 829, flying to 240 degrees. Cleared RST 7 left. Flying 240
degrees,
clear RST
127 left.
Alright, trims reset.
Virgin 2-4, sorry, 2-5 Bravo, direct.
London Heliman 27 Alpha, we're arriving on scene at Beaconsfield. We'll be landing shortly. We'll call you for departure.
Heliman 27 Alpha, roger.
Gear down. Alright, let's just get in and have a little look at this just to make sure there's no wires or anything coming across. It doesn't look like there's any high tension wires around this area. Instance on the left hand side there. Seem to be in the middle of a street. So it maybe a bit of a tight LZ. Airspeed's below 90 knots, we'll take the rotor RPM at 102% now. Trim has been reset, the gear's down, I see free grains. Okay, there's the incident straight in front of us there. The wind is 222 at 9 knots. Wind's coming from our left. Alright, doesn't look like there's any high tension wires down there. There's a lot of poles though. More poles than Warsaw down there. So we're going to flip around. We're going to come around to the right hand side. We're going to land. There's a patch of grass just to the left hand side of the incident there. That's where we're going to be landing. Alright, 60 knots. We're approaching Dead Man's Curve now. Trim is life.
25 Bravo, call London 132.6, goodbye.
Alright, let's start really slowing down, get the aircraft down below 50 knots. I see a visual in a police car.
London, good evening. Speedbird 444 with you on the Britman's Park, 7 Foxtrot.
Okay, the nose is more or less in the wind. The wind's coming from 5 degrees to the right at 9 knots. I'm happy to crab in here. In fact, we're going to land on the road, guys. I'm going to come to the left. No obstacles on the left hand side. I'm going to come around these poles here and we're going to crab to the right hand side and touch down. Ah, fuck, now that I see this approach, it probably would have been better to come in from the other way, but never mind, I'll work this out. Roger, category alpha selected. Alright, rotor set to 102%. I see free greens. I'm happy with the power, I'm happy with the airspeed. Alright, I see that pole there, I see the pole in front of us on the right near the ambulance. We're just going to get the aircraft in the middle here and then I'm going to transition over to the right, so we're going to hold here. It's a little bit too far forward.
Good evening, Ryanair 282.
Alright, stabilise.
Flight level 190 inbound Midhurst.
Very similar to what we were doing in the Harrier jump jet. Alright, we're going to transition just nice and easy over to the right.
When ready, flight level 150, Ryanair 282. You got 42 miles to run, descent altitude 6,000 feet on the QNH 1000.
Right, wind's coming from the left, about 30 degrees at 9 knots.
6,000 feet,
QNH 1000, down we go. Anytime now, Maverick, this kid's dying, bro. Alright, stabilise any ground effect, and let's get her down. Touching down. Alright, main gear's down, let's get the nose wheel down. We are down. Gently centre the collective, centre the cyclic and pedals to neutral. Rotor to 100%.
Izzy 9009, Medlinic 315. 315,
Izzy 9. Nailed it! Oh. Alright, we should be able to see this kid. There he is there, look, he's giving us a thumbs up! He's in the helicopter now, he's despawned. He's okay though, he's giving us a thumbs up, guys. The patient is now on board. He is heavily sedated and stable for now, but the doctors are very worried about his heart. He needs to get to the waiting trauma team as fast as possible or he won't make it. Let's go, pilot, do your thing and make it fast. Roger that. Alright, we'll take flight on one. Flight on two. Right, we're outside of controlled airspace. I don't need to call this controller to get in the air. Trim's been reset. We have flight on both engines. We're good on the left. We're good on the right. Collective is idle. We're going to come any ground effect, and we're going to come out to the right. All right, power's coming up. Nose up. And we'll bring the right wheel off the ground first. Here we go. And up. Stabilise into ground effect. Don't go backwards because there's a big pole behind us on the left hand side. And we're going to come back and right. Here we go. Rotor speed to 102%.
Good evening, Speedberg 719.
Nose any wind.
Descending flight level 180.
2719, London Control, Roger. Is he 9009? Just looks like you're descending there.
Yeah, I don't know, something happened there, but we're correcting that now. You know, so I don't know.
Roger.
Okay, gear up. Nose forward, wait for physics to catch up. And we'll start moving forward. Once we get through 50 knots, we're through ETL, here it comes. And before we get to 90 knots, we'll take the rotor RPM back to 100%, and we'll contact London Control for our entry back into controlled airspace. I'm going to slow the aircraft down just a little bit here.
Rhino 282, descent flight level 90.
Descent flight level 90, Rhino 282.
London Helimed 27 Alpha, we're airborne from Beaconsfield, sir. We're holding at Cookham, we'd like to enter controlled airspace westbound, correction, eastbound on Hotel 10 for Perivale. Perivale direct to the Royal London Hospital.
Hello, 27 Alpha London, Roger, see clear to enter the London control zone. Hotel 10 eastbound, Perivale, then direct to the Royal London. Standard operating altitude for London QNH now 999 hectopascal.
Clear to enter controlled airspace on track, Royal London, eastbound on Hotel 10 to Perivale, direct to Royal London. Standard operating altitudes 9 or 9 or 9 for Helimed 27 Alpha. Many thanks.
27 Alpha, correct. Break easy 9009, descend on chute 3.
Okay, let's go.
3000 feet, easy 9009.
Speedbird 719, descend flight level 100.
Descend the flight level 100.
Altitude will definitely help. Good to see you, Arkav. Welcome back. What's up, Cosmic Gaming? He was given the good... Airbus 737 says he was given the good stuff before the flight. He was high out his nut, bro. This young man's on a lot of drugs.
Ooh,
what's that wind coming from? Alright, trim his life. Let's get up above 500 feet AGL here. Come on, Trim, help a brother out, for fuck's sake.
Rhino 282, descend flight level 80.
Flyby.
Descend flight level 80, Rhino 282.
Oh shit, I'm way off track for where I should be. Alright, we're heading for Iverheath and then Uxbridge. We have 29 minutes to make it to the hospital. Plenty of time. Plenty of time. Such a bad effect that. We really need to take that out of the game. What a gorgeous helicopter though. Alright, coming up to Iverheath. From Iverheath we're going eastbound to Uxbridge. Gary Lauderdale, what's up big dog, on YouTube? When you flew as Concorde, what aircraft type did... Yes, Charlie Oscar November Charlie.
Turn right, heading 320 degrees, speed bar 709.
Oh, my head is banging! Okay, we're over Iverheath, we're coming left for Uxbridge and then out to RAF Norfolk. There's RAF Norfolk on the left hand side there. Do me a favour, guys, if you're watching on YouTube and you're enjoying the stream, hit that thumbs up button. If you're not enjoying the stream, you know what to do. You know what to do, goddammit! Hey, MX, welcome. Good to see you again, brother. Jesus Christ, Diamond. Fucking slow down, bro. Alright, dude, I see you, bro. I see you. Just fucking chill out. Fucking hell. Alright. Well, fuck off, then. Fuck off, you little dweeb. Fucking dumbass. There's always one moron every stream, guys. There's always one fucking moron. Diamond Games. Well done, Diamond Games. You're the moron for this stream, bro. Thanks for showing up. I hope to never see you again. Hey, Psycho, what are we doing, he asks on YouTube. We're on our way to the Royal London Hospital with a young man that's been hit by a bus. We've got a patient that's been ran over. We just flew over and landed on the west side of London to pick him up. Now we're taking the patient to the hospital.
Right now, 282, turn left heading 100 degrees. Turn left heading 100 degrees, right now 282.
So you see all these high-rise buildings up in the distance there? That the hospital's just on the other side of those high-rise buildings, so we don't have far to go. We just passed London Heathrow, actually. It's, if I can hold on, get a quick external view and I'll show you. There's Heathrow right there. See it? Sorry, my scenery is loading.
Descent altitude 4,000 feet, QNH
9. MX says the scenery looks amazing. It's very good, dude. It's Orbix. Orbix South. Expensive, but well worth the money, my friend. Well worth it. I want to try and keep the AGL above 500 feet. We're at 620 feet right now, so that's okay. Arcav says, Mav, check this when you have time. Check what, bro? Dude, send me a link on Discord, bro. I'm never going to click the link if it's in the chat, my man. If you want me to have a look at something, send me a message on Discord. Alright, Pennyvale, direct to Royal London.
Not a problem. You're still close to the RS 27 after descent of 3,000 feet.
Now we get to do this direct from Pennyvale to the hospital because we're in a twin engine helicopter. In the Gazelle we can't really do this, we have to follow Hotel 10 to Hotel 4, it's a bit of a pain in the ass. Hey, Nick Talavera, what a great name, on YouTube asks, what is this game? This is called X-Plane 11, my friend. X-Plane 11, and we're on the VATSIM network, which is all the ATC that you can hear. I'll get the hand cam up as well so you guys can see me landing.
Oh,
why is that all wonky? Sorry guys, stuff's all over the place. Ah, this is a mess. Sorry dudes. Oh shit, I'm crashing! Watch out for that crane! I got it. No, we're way too low, bro.
Speedbird 985, turn left, heading 240 degrees.
Left 240 degrees, speedbird 985.
Right now 282, this altitude 2,000 feet.
Alright, there's Parliament there. There's a London Eye. Yeah, Nick, this is X-Plane, dude. I got payware graphics, I got payware scenery, so. London Heliman 27 Alpha, we have the Royal London in sight.
27 Alpha, thank you. The service wind at London City is 240 degrees at 10 knots.
27 Alpha. Alright, over London Bridge, and then we'll start rooting around to the left.
Speedbird 985, descent to altitude 6,000 feet, the QNH 999 next.
Okay, here we
6,
go.
6,000 feet, QNH 999 right there, speedbird 985.
Right at 282, turn left, heading 285, clear down at 26 left. Left heading 285 degrees, cleared ILS.
Alright, gear down.
26 left, right at 280.
Why is that not working?
Gear down. Feet,
when's coming from 240?
ILS 26 left.
Just stand by, please. Easy 901, descent altitude 6,000.
Some guys on the ILS for 26 left at 15,000 feet. Slightly above the glide slope, bro. Okay, we are below 90 knots. We'll take the rotor RPM to 102%. We'll keep this left trend coming. We'll get the nose into wind and we'll crab it on down. Alright, nose is into wind. We'll come in at this angle here. Gears down, I see three greens. Rotor RPM is set to 102%. I'm happy with the power, I'm happy with the speed, and I am happy with the rate of descent.
4,000 feet right, T50 speed, but 95.
Tower
124.225. Careful with VRS, dude.
124.225, run at 282.
Let's keep this forward train coming all the way down.
Uniform Leadman 1986, London. Hello,
D. Gears down, three greens.
90.
Category Alpha selected.
Good evening, flight level 90, thank you.
Speedbird 985, report established.
Alright, nose into wind.
Report established, T7F, speedbird 985.
Keep coming forward on the trend. Not too fast, dude. Alright, stabilise any ground effect, the gear is down. Stabilise. And land. 3, 2, 1. Touching down. Alright, the main gear is down, let's get the nose wheel down now. Rotor RPM back to 100%. Gently centre the collective. And the cyclic and the pedals. We're down. MX says that Emma from Kolimata announced today that the next Concorde systems update will maybe be in December. That'd be a great Christmas present. A great Christmas present. Airbus 737 on YouTube says the Thames looks pretty and X-Plane 11 not so much in flight sim. Henrik, welcome on board, big dog. Just joined your stream. Did you use FSP3D before? No, brother. I've never used Prepared. I've only ever used Microsoft Flight Simulator or X-Plane. Hey, Annex joined us on Twitch. Good evening. Thanks, Airbus. Max Rank on Twitch says, on YouTube says, thinking about buying this shopper, question is, should I? Pretty late in the land of haggis, fella. Enjoying the stream. Not that bad, dude. It's only 10 to 10 in the evening, so it's not that bad. It's a great aircraft, dude. This is money well spent if you buy this. It's a great aircraft. I don't regret buying it. It's great. What's up, Finlay? Welcome. MX says, oh yeah, same what I said on Colin Matt Discord. Nice. What's up, TDR? Welcome along. Alright, guys, my head is fucking banging. I've got a really, really sore head. I've been up since 2 o'clock. Yeah, no, sorry, 2:30 in the morning is when my alarm went off. So I've been up for a long time. I've drank too much coffee today and I haven't drank enough water, so my head is fucking killing me. So I'm going to go back to the London heliport and then that'll do for today.
I'm going to be closing in just a minute, so it's just Unicom 1228, please.
Well done, pilot. The doctors think because we got here so quickly, the boy has a real chance. If he had come by road, he would not have stood a chance. Great work, Captain. You're goddamn right. All right, let's get that on before London gets off. London, Helimed 27 Echo, we're ready to lift at the Royal London Hospital. We'd like to enter controlled airspace westbound on Hotel 4 for the London heliport.
Helimed 27 Echo, thank you. So you cleared the London heliport to join controlled airspace, Hotel 4 westbound, standard operating altitudes, VFR.
Hotel 4 westbound, standard operating altitudes, VFR. Many thanks, Helimed 27 Echo, we're lifting now. Alright, Roar RPM selected to 102%. We have flight on both ratings. We're clear on the left, we're clear on the right. The cyclic's good, we're ready to go.
Air France 3083, descent altitude 6,000 feet. The Kilo 999,
and we'll take the right wheel off the ground first. Stabilise. And we're going to come back and left.
901, descent altitude 2,000 feet. Easy 95 Yankee Victor, report you're heading to London, 132.6, goodbye.
Gear up.
132.6, easy 95 Yankee Victor, goodnight.
Okay, we're through ETL, rotor RPM back to 100%. Check that the gear is up. The gear is up. We're flying away.
Delta Uniform Lima 1986, turn left, heading 095.
Turn left, heading 095, Delta Uniform Lima 1986.
You know what time it is!
Landing gear. Landing gear.
Is that landing gear, Warren?
Because we're a little bit too low. Landing control.
Go. Shit myself.
Sierra Bravo, Cessna 172, Birmingham with information.
Airbus on YouTube asks, is it customary to depart backwards like that in a helicopter? Yes, brother. That is called a Category Alpha departure. So that's for departing confined areas or helipads. The reason why we do that is in case we have an engine failure. Technically, well, on paper, if we have an engine failure, we could auto-rotate back onto where we took off from. There's several different types of Category Alpha departure in a helicopter. You also have Category Bravo departures, which are generally take off, stabilise into ground effect, and then start flying forward. Around about maybe like 20 or 30 feet, get through ETL and then start climbing the aircraft up. But a Category Alpha departure is, you get Category Alpha landings as well. Alpha, Category Alpha landings, Category Bravo landings. But generally all confined areas are all going to be a Category Alpha departure. So it's either straight back, back and left, back and right, straight left, straight right. But it's all about, if we have an engine failure, we have the ability to auto-rotate back into where we took off from. Hey Cooper, welcome on Twitch, brother. Good, welcome. All right, the wind is 240 at 9 knots. We're heading for the London heliport, guys. You can get the scenery for Prepared and for X-Plane for just £1 or $1, €1, wherever you live. Get yourself along at charityscenery.co.uk. I don't make any money from it, guys. All the money goes to charity. All the money raised goes to air ambulance charities in the United Kingdom. So, charityscenery.co.uk. We're doing good things. We are doing good things. Sheffy asks what I do for a job in real life. I am a truck driver in real life, sir. All right, let's start slowing down. Helimed 27 Echo, we have the London heliport in sight.
27 Echo, thanks very much. Land at your discretion, the surface wind is 220 degrees at 10 knots.
Thanks so much for your help today, sir. Great job as usual, Fraser. Much appreciated. Helimed 27 Echo. Okay, the wind is coming from back and left here, so I'm going to do a little bit of a manoeuvre. Hashtag manoeuvre.
8901, you just missed the localizer there. Are you visual with 26 left?
All right, roar RPM to 102%. This could go horribly wrong.
124.225. Goodbye.
All right, right pedal. Don't bin it, Maverick. Don't bin it. Don't bin it. Don't bin it. Don't bin it. I got it. Okay, here we go.
Delta Uniform 1986, I am closing now.
Gears down, rotor RPM is selected to 102%, happy with the power, happy with the landing area. Wind's coming from slightly to the left.
Goodbye, thanks very much for your help, have a good day.
Thank you.
In fact, I totally fucked that up, we'll go around.
When established, call the tower at 118.5, goodbye.
I would be landing with a tailwind there, it wouldn't be a problem because the wind's only at 9 knots, but I'm a bit of a stickler for being anal and doing stuff properly.
London is now closed. Monitor unicom, please. 1-2-2.
We're doing our little.
London is now closed. 1-2-2.
Wing over here. Make us a bit more aggressive. Don't crash, Maverick. I got it. All right, careful with the envelope. All right. I've made life really difficult for myself here. I can't see shit. Alright, let's get this stable. Get this stabled out. They definitely would land like this in real life. What they would do is, in fact, you know what, I'm going to land and then I'm going to take off again and come in how they would actually land in real life if the wind was like this. Alright, come on bro, you went way too far forward there, dude, sort that out. Keep coming, get over there. Get over there, you fucker. Alright, stabilise. Alright, that was a horrible entry onto the pad, but I got away with it. Touching down. Alright, so we're facing into wind right now. So I fucked that up, I'll be honest, guys. Didn't do a good job. Rotor RPM back to 100%. Watch out for that crane. We're going to come up and left this time.
150.
Hopefully I'm not going to crash. A little bit too much torque on there. Alright, up. Take the power off. And full left pedal. Oh, she does not like that. Alright, down we go. Gears down, free greens. Airspeed's below 90 knots, 102 RPM selected. Hey, Vasek, thanks, man. I love your skill. Thanks, brother. That's very kind of you. So yeah, in real life, they wouldn't land the way I just landed the first time. They would, if the wind's coming from that direction, this is how they would. They would just approach, just coming in straight, because the wind's not too bad. It's 9 knots from the right. It's basically just a case of lining up onto the center line here. Keep coming forward with a trend. The gear's down three greens. Rotor RPM is selected to 102%. I'm happy with the power, the airspeed, and the rate of descent. Here we go. Forward visibility is a bit of a bitch. Keep it coming with a forward trend. Forward trend, dude. Don't let it stop. Keep coming. Stabilize any ground effect. And land. Touching down. Nose wheel down. Gently lower the collective. Gently center the cyclic. And gently neutral the pedals. Oh, my fucking hand, bro. Jesus Christ. Roar RPM to 100%. We'll take the brakes off. And I should be able to taxi forward here. I hate trying to taxi these fucking helicopters on the ground, dude. It's much harder to taxi on the ground than it is to fly in real life. To fly in the air. Fly in real life. Alright, forward, you fucker! Dude, the fucking wheel's coming off right. Why isn't this working? Come on! Cyclic forward. Oh. Alright, maybe just some more collective then. Collective. Alright, cyclic slightly forward. Go forward! Oh Christ, it wants to take off. You know what? Fuck it. I will just fly over. Fuck you! I will just fly over. Thank you very much. Touching down. Nose wheel down. Hey, A from the dead, welcome, buddy. Vasek on YouTube said, our police pilot could learn from you, but we only have a Eurocopter and Bell. Where do you live, brother? Max Rank says, just about to wrap up Heathrow to Hong Kong, VATSIM! Never again! I'll pick this bird up on your recommendation. Cheers for the feedback. What's the mission generator? It's called the Helicopter Rescue Missions mod, dude. You can check it out on charityscenery.co.uk, bro. If you go to that website and go to the shop, there's a link that you can get the rescue mod. You can get the rescue mod for free, and you can make a donation to charityscenery.co.uk for just like £1. And then you can get the UK Air Ambulance version of the Helicopter Rescue mod, my friend. Do I recognise you? You are AE Slideways. I vaguely remember the name, young man. I'm not sure if I like you or not, though, bro. But I do recognise the name. In fact, I remember. I actually don't like you. You're a little shit. I remember who you are. All right, guys, that's going to do it for... In fact, you know what? Let's get the aircraft shut down first. Push for off. 1, 2. Engine rating for that. And we'll take the fuel pump for 2 off, fuel pump for 1 off, fuel valve for 2, fuel valve for 1. And we'll return the throttles back to off. And we'll take generator 1 and 2 can go now as well. Park and brake is on, roar RPM is dialed down. We can lose the steering light, sorry, the probe can go off, anti-collision, position lights can come off as well, PTO heat can come off. avionics and the master battery can come off now as well. And we'll just actually leave the rotor RPM to spool down. In real life, they would leave the sit at idle for 2 minutes in the Augusta 139. It's like an SOP, a standard procedure that they actually sit on the ground for 2 minutes before they can shut down the engine. Luckily, because I'm flying on a simulator, I don't have to adhere to those restrictions. All right, guys, that's going to do it. My fucking head is banging. I've got such a sore head. I'm in a shitty mood now as well. I will, I'm working tomorrow. I start, like I said, I've just started a new job. I'm not really sure how long I'm going to be working for, so I might stream in the morning if I don't go out and play golf. If I don't go out and play golf, I definitely will stream, guys. But if I don't stream, that means I went out and played golf. So I will see you guys, if not tomorrow, I'll catch you guys on Thursday or Friday. Look after yourselves. Do something nice for a stranger if you can, guys. Remember to sit up straight in your chair as well. Top Gun in volleyball. I am not Scott Manley. Fly safe. Man, Two-Tone, I just caught you at the end there, brother, sorry. Two-Tone says, howdy fella, where did the centre map for the 139 come from? It's actually a mod, Two-Tone. I've seen you streaming on YouTube, by the way. Run a great little stream over there, son. I've enjoyed watching, and I like to lurk on your channel sometimes when you're flying around. Keep up the great work, sir. If you just go onto Google and type in Augusta 139 X-Plane, it's called the Avitab. I'll put that in for you here, bro. Sorry I can't send you a link, my friend, because I don't have it, but that's what you want to search, dude. Avitab, and then you'll it's a very straightforward installation, bro. You just drop a little folder into the actual aircraft itself. You're a very smart man, Mr. Murphy. I'm sure you're going to work it out. Take care of yourself. I will see you guys next time. Peace.